In the Build Flows with SAS Studio demonstration, you saw how steps could be assembled into a flow to orchestrate a series of actions to prepare and analyze data. But what if you have your own custom code that you would like to make available as a step that could be integrated in a flow or executed independently? This is possible with SAS Studio Custom Steps. If you have access to SAS Studio, I encourage you to follow along with me. Your environment may already have the files used in this demo. However, if you don't see them, please visit our SAS Software GitHub page. The SAS Viya Quick Start repository provides the files used in our demonstrations and instructions to load them into your environment. From the Applications menu, select Develop Code and Flows to open SAS Studio. In the Explorer, navigate to your Quick Start folder and double-click printsample.sas. This program prints a subset from the sashelp.homeequity table. The %let statement defines a macro variable named selection. The value assigned to selection will determine if the subset is the first rows or a random sample. The procsql step reflects the total row count from sashelp.homeequity and stores it in a macro variable named n. The total row count is used later in the titles. This section executes if the macro variable selection resolves to first. Titles are assigned, then the data step reads the first 20 rows and a subset of the columns from sashelp.homeequity. The subset is saved in a temporary table named sample. The next section executes if the selection macro variable resolves to any value other than first. Alternate titles are assigned, and procsurveySelect applies the simple random sample method to choose 20 rows. The selected rows and columns are also saved in a temporary table named sample. Finally, a custom footnote is created with the current date and time, and procprint prints the sample table. I'll run the program. The report title indicates the sample includes the first 20 of 5,960 rows. Back in the Code tab, I'll modify the %let statement by replacing first with random. I'll run the program and confirm that the title indicates a random sample size of 20 rows. I'll close the program tab and I won't save the changes. A custom step can provide a simple interface to allow users to run this program with custom options, including choosing the table and columns, sample size, and selection method. Begin by selecting New and Custom Step. A new tab opens, labeled CustomStep.step. The layout includes three subtabs. The designer provides a point-and-click visual tool to build the user interface. The control library on the left includes the features available to add to the step. The canvas area in the center is where you build the step. The properties pane on the right is where you define attributes for the pages and controls in the step. The prompt UI includes the JSON code produced from the designer. And the program includes the SAS code that will be modified based on user input and executed. In the Explorer, drag the printsample.sas program and drop it onto the Program tab. We'll modify the program to utilize the input controls built in the designer. So let's go to the designer. I'll begin by adding controls that allow the user to select a table and columns from which to print the subset. In the control library, find input table and drag it to the canvas. The properties pane on the right includes various attributes that we can customize. The ID value is the name of a SAS macro variable that will store the selected table name. The red asterisk indicates that the value must be provided for this property. SAS Studio provides a default value, but you can change it. I'll type table. The label value is the text that appears in the interface above the control. Type select input table, and the canvas will reflect the changes. Additional options allow you to further customize the control. Type SAS Help in the default library field and Home Equity in the default table field. Next, we'll add a control to choose columns from the selected table. Find Column Selector in the control library and drag it to the bottom of the canvas. In the ID field, type var list. The control will produce a macro variable named var list that stores a space-delimited list of all selected columns. In the label field, type select columns to print. In the Link to Input Table field, choose Select Input Table or Table so that the available columns will be derived from the table selected in the Input Table control we created earlier. To verify the interaction of the first two controls, click Preview. A new tab opens. Click the plus sign next to Select Columns to Print, and verify columns from the Home Equity table are listed. Now that the table and column selector controls are added, the SAS program must be modified to insert the table name and column list in the appropriate places. Right-click on the program and select Find and Replace. In the Find What field, type sashelp.homeequity. In the Replace With field, type /table. Remember, the ID value of the table selector control was table, which represents a macro variable. Each occurrence of /table in the program will be replaced with the selected table name before the program executes. Click Replace All and Close. In the Program tab, find the Keep Equal option on both the Set and Proc Survey Select statements. Replace the list of columns after each Keep Equal option with /varlist. Click the Save icon to save the custom step. Expand Folder Shortcuts and select Shortcut to My Folder. I'll name my custom step Print Sample and click Save. To test the step, select the Steps pane on the left and click Shared. Right-click the Print Sample step and select Open in a tab. In the new Print Sample tab, use the column selector to choose Bad, Loan, Mortgage Due, and Value. Click OK and Run. Confirm that a report is generated listing the first 20 rows from sashelp.homeequity and the four selected columns. Select Code Panel in the upper right corner to examine the generated code. Look for the comment Region Generate Macro Initialization at approximately line 140 and expand the section. This portion of the program creates the macro variables corresponding to each control. The table macro variable is created and assign a value of sashelp.homeequity. But notice additional macro variables storing supplemental information about the selected table are available. The varlist macro variable is created. The assigned value is the space-delimited list of the selected columns, but notice multiple macro variables are created for each selected column. These supplemental macro variables can be used in the custom step program for more complex macro processing. I'll return to the PrintSample.step tab. In the Designer, click Add Page to add a second page containing additional options. It's helpful to label each page to identify the contents. Click Page 1 in the Properties pane and type Data in both the ID and Label fields. Click Page 2 in the Properties pane and type Options in both fields. The canvas reflects the new page names. There are additional aspects of the program that can be customized based on user input. For example, a numeric control can specify the number of rows to include in the subset. With the Options page active, drag the numeric stepper control to the canvas. In the ID field, type num rows. In the label field, type number of rows to print. Select the required and allow integer value only checkboxes. In the default value field, type 20. In the minimum value field, type 1. Leave the maximum field value blank. And in the step size field, type 5. Select the Program tab to modify the code to use the numRows macro variable. Right-click on the program and select Find and Replace. In the Find What field, type 20. In the Replace With field, type %numRows and click Replace All and Close. Recall that the code includes a macro variable named Selection and conditional %if statements that specify if the first n rows or a random sample should be printed. A control can be added to the step that will allow the user to select the method in the interface rather than the code. Select the Designer tab and verify that the Options page is active. Find Radio Button Group in the control library and drag it to the bottom of the canvas. In the ID field, type selection. This matches the existing macro variable in the program. In the label field, type selection method. In the value field, type first in uppercase. Click Map Values to assign a label. Type first n rows in the label field. The value will be assigned to the selection macro variable, but the label will be displayed in the interface. In the field below Add and Organize Items, type random and click the plus sign. In the label field, type random sample. View the program. The radio button group control will automatically create the macro variable name selection and assign a value based on the user's choice. So we don't need the %let statement. I can delete it. If the user selects first n rows from the radio buttons, then first will be assigned to the selection macro variable, and the data step will create the subset. Otherwise, the proc survey select step will execute to produce the random sample. Notice in the proc survey select statement that the method equal option value is SRS, which is a simple random sample without replacement. There are many other sampling methods available, such as URS, which is an unrestricted random sample with replacement. If a user selects the random sample method, we can provide a dependent choice to choose either SRS or URS. Return to the designer. Drag the drop-down list control to the bottom of the canvas. In the ID field, type RS method. In the label field, type random sample method. Select the required checkbox. Click Add Many and type SRS and URS on separate rows. And click OK. Select the Map Values button. Next to SRS, type Simple Random Sample without replacement. And next to URS, type Unrestricted Random Sample with replacement. In the default item field, select Simple Random Sample without replacement. This drop-down list control should only appear if the random sample radio button is selected. This can be controlled with dependencies. Verify the drop-down list control is selected, and in the Properties pane, select Dependencies. In the Visibility box, type the following JSON expression. Bracket quote dollar sign selection quote, comma, quote equal quote, comma, and quote random quote, then close the bracket. To learn more about the syntax for dependencies, search SAS documentation for SAS Custom Steps Create Dependencies. Select the Program tab. In the Proc Survey Select statement, replace SRS with &RS method. Click Save. Select the Print Sample tab to test the completed custom step. I'll select Refresh the definition of the custom step. And I'll make the following selections. In the Select Input Table Control, I'll choose SAS Help, Baseball. In the Select Columns to Print Control, I'll select All Columns. On the Options page, change the number of rows to 25. Change the selection method to Random Sample. And as soon as we do that, we see the additional control appear. Accept the default as Simple Random Sample without replacement. Click Run. And confirm the report is successfully generated. Running a custom step in a tab is what we also refer to as standalone mode, but custom steps can also be used in a flow. To demonstrate this, I'll select New and Flow. In the Steps pane, I'll select SAS Steps and drag Table to the flow. In the Table Properties, I'll select the SAS Help Library and Quakes as the table. In the Steps pane, I'll select Shared and drag Print Sample to the right edge of the Quakes node so that the prompt says Connect to Output Port. With Print Sample selected in the flow, the Data page is active below. Note that the Table Selector is not visible because the input table is derived from the flow. The Column Selector automatically lists the columns from the sashelp.quakes table. I'll select all columns and click OK. In the Options pane, I'll change the number of rows to print to 10 and accept the default to print the first n rows. I'll click Run at the top of the flow. Click Submitted Code and Results to view the generated report. It looks great. Besides creating your own custom steps, you can collaborate with other users who are also creating custom steps for SAS Studio. A rich library of shareable custom steps is maintained by SAS at github.com/software/SAS Studio custom steps. There are many .step files that can be downloaded from the repository and uploaded into your SAS Studio. You can use them either in standalone mode or in a flow.